Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the University of Wisconsin-La Crosse Department of Music, we welcome you to Annett Recital Hall, where we present to you this evening Duo 970 performing a guest artist recital. Please take this time to turn off all electronic devices, especially those that may make disruptive noise or have bright screens that may distract and disturb others. Remember, eating, drinking, talking, and flash photography are prohibited. Again, welcome and enjoy the performance.
Thanks for coming out tonight. We are really glad that we made it here from the Twin Cities. That whole adage, the show must go on, really applied today. We wanted to make sure that we got here. I just wanted to let you know that the program has the first two pieces. We're actually switching the order tonight, so we're going to be starting with the second piece on the program, Songbird by Stephanie Boyd. I want to tell you a little bit about this piece. Stephanie is a New York-based composer, born and raised in Michigan. And a few years ago, 2015, 2016, somewhere around there, she did a really interesting commission, consortium of violinists who commissioned a what she called a 50 states violin sonata. And so essentially the idea was that she had one commissioner violinist in each of the 50 states of the US, and then each of those commissioners had exclusive performance rights in their state for a period of time. And when the piece was commissioned, the commissioner for Colorado premiered the piece there. Susie was the one that got to play with that violinist. Who was the violinist?
Sherry Wang.
Oh, okay. Yes. And so, and Stephanie came to that performance. So Susie got to know Stephanie a little bit and got to work with her on the piece and get, you know, some feedback and, you know, performance and all that. And then a couple of years later, when Susie and I decided we wanted to start commissioning music, we were brainstorming about composers, and she said, well, what about Stephanie? Because she wrote this great violin sonata. It was really wonderful. So I went and listened to her music and immediately thought, yes, this composer is really great. So we reached out to her, and she said, well, as a matter of fact, I was already thinking about doing a 50 States flute sonata. And it didn't turn out to be all 50 states, but there are a good number of commissioners involved. But we really got lucky. Timing is kind of everything. But the piece, we made this discussion with her at kind of in the fall of 2019, and everyone knows what happened at the beginning of 2020. And so everything just came to a grinding halt. There were no performances, no premieres, no nothing. But Stephanie took that time to write the piece and ended up kind of finishing it ahead of schedule. So the following summer, when we were finally able to perform again, we had a rescheduled concert that was originally supposed to be in the summer of 2020 in Paris, and it was rescheduled for the summer of 2021, and we were able to do the world premiere of this piece then. We've also been really fortunate to be touring with the piece, and so we've been able to play it not only in our sort of home commissioning area, but we've been able to play it lots of places, including now Wisconsin and Minnesota. So we're really thrilled to share this piece with you. It is a three-movement work based on bird songs. Stephanie talks about the piece being inspired by going out on the rooftops in Manhattan and hearing no traffic noise and no people noise and no nothing during the hard lockdown that was happening in New York City, and just hearing the birds sing for the first time. And so she said that she was inspired to write the opening melody by a robin that was just perched on a tree right outside, right, you know, across from the rooftop she was on, and hearing it singing, and she wrote it down. You'll hear robins, cardinals, loons, mourning doves, directly quoted in this. And then the last piece, she said, is inspired by the formations of starlings, sort of as you can imagine that when you see starlings flying in formation and they look like otherworldly sort of clouds and things sort of making shapes in the sky. So that's what the last movement is based on. So this is Stephanie Ann Boyd's song.
No. Thank you.
Next piece on this program may be known to some of you, maybe some of the flutists in the room know it, but it's Robert Muczynski is a composer that died relatively recently, so for many of us, I know for you know, faculty, people our age, grew up with Muczynski being a living composer, working and teaching and doing all those things, and so he only recently died, like in the last decade. But this piece was written in 1965, and Muczynski was born and raised in Chicago, and spent a lot of his childhood, you know, in the 1930s and 40s, watching film noir, watching this sort of genre of films that were popular at the time that are in black and white, and had this sort of quality about them where everything sort of took place in the shadows, and there was a lot of sort of mystery, and but also with themes of sort of gangsters and gunfights and bank robberies and car chases, long before, you know, movies like The Fast and the Furious. So this genre of filmmaking heavily influenced his music. In fact, someone asked us the other night if this music was ever used in films, and I don't think that it was, but when you hear it, it actually sounds like it could have been. This piece is in four movements. They're all relatively short, but sort of fast and furious themselves.
Thank you.
Okay, so for the third piece on our program, it's another sonata, but this is a work that is not originally for flute. Some of you who have studied music or know a lot of classical music might know the name of this composer, Richard Strauss, who wrote a lot of music. He was very prolific, and he lived a really long time, well into his 80s. He was a child prodigy, and this piece was actually written while he was in his 20s. If you know any of the orchestral music of Strauss, you might know some of the tone poems like Till Eulenspiegel and Don Juan and some of those really famous pieces. This piece comes from that sort of style of Strauss's writing. So lots of characters, lots of sort of action that can be seen in the music, although none of it is strictly programmatic. There's no story being told here, it's just a sonata. But you can hear a lot of characters and ideas in the piece that come back throughout the piece. So this piece was originally written for violin. It's a violin sonata. Works well on the flute, but as many transcriptions of violin music, there are a few changes that had to be made to make it work on the instrument, a few octave differences. But for the most part, it's pretty much straightforward what Strauss wrote. So three movements, and we hope that you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.